We all know that copying doesn't always guarantee success. This is once again demonstrated by the engine recently unveiled by a Chinese company, which appears to be a direct copy of SpaceX's Raptor 3. At first glance, the engine appears very similar, but behind the resemblance lies a significant number of flaws. One might even wonder if they're mocking themselves. So what methods did China use to copy SpaceX's Raptor 3 engine, and what are the reasons for its perceived failure? Let's discuss all of this in today's episode of NR Studio. To date, China has copied almost all of SpaceX's technology. The numbers are staggering, highlighting the extent to which the imitation approach has been adopted. However, as we have seen time and again, not all imitations are successful. The most recent example is Zhu Yunjian's reproduction of the Raptor 3 engine, abbreviated as JVYJ. To save time, I will simply call it JITCH. The name translates to Chinese Cloud Aero, and the company was founded in 2017. It operates as a private entity, though it is not as well known as competitors like Landspace, Space Pioneer, or CAS Space, primarily because it does not have an operational launch vehicle. To date, the company has focused on building a single engine, which happens to be a clone of the SpaceX engine we're discussing today. This new engine is called the FY-100. It uses liquid methane and oxygen as fuel and utilizes a full-staged combustion cycle. These specifications are identical to SpaceX's Raptor engine. The similarities don't stop there. The engine's design also adheres to the same minimalist principles SpaceX adopted with the Raptor 3. Instead of featuring a complex network of smaller exterior components common to conventional rocket engines, the FY-100 has a more streamlined and cohesive structure. According to SpaceX's specifications, this simplified design on the Raptor 3 was achieved by eliminating smaller subsystems or combining them into larger, more efficient assemblies. Even the arrangement of the oxygen pump, methane pump, hot gas manifold, and pre-combustor is nearly identical to the Raptor design. Perhaps the only noticeable difference is the color. The FY-100 has a bright silvery-gray hue, while the Raptor 3 features a sleek, matte black exterior. Beyond the visual similarities, the company has revealed some technical specifications. While JITCH hasn't officially revealed the exact engine size, slides from the latest presentation provide some clues. The information indicates that a 4.2-meter diameter rocket can accommodate 9 engines, a 5-meter diameter rocket can accommodate 12 engines, a 7-meter diameter rocket can accommodate 24 engines, and similarly, a 9-meter rocket is also capable of carrying 24 engines. From these calculations, it is estimated that the FY-100 has a diameter of about 1.1 meters, which is slightly less than the 1.3 meters of the Raptor 3. Consequently, the FY-100 weighs under 1 metric ton, while the Raptor 3 exceeds 1.5 metric tons. Regarding its performance specifications, the FY-100 offers approximately 127 tons of thrust at sea level with a specific impulse of 325 seconds, while in a vacuum it produces 150 tons of thrust with a specific impulse of 370 seconds. JITZIC has indicated aspirations to achieve higher performance metrics in the future. However, these values still lag far behind SpaceX's Raptor 3, which is capable of delivering 280 tons of thrust at sea level and 306 tons in a vacuum. The power and efficiency of SpaceX's engines are far superior. The company is poised to begin test firings of the FY-100 early next year. This progress illustrates JITZIC's ambitions alongside China's broader goal of directly challenging SpaceX. Their presentation also hinted at future rocket designs of varying diameters, suggesting plans to create a series of launch vehicles that could compete with Falcon and Starship on performance metrics. A closer look at the presentation reveals several key elements. The bottom of the rocket design includes fins, indicating that it will not employ flaps for re-entry management like Starship does. Furthermore, no landing legs are visible, suggesting JITZIC re-pursue a recovery approach similar to SpaceX's system that uses a mechanical arm for retrieval. The company has already created a prototype intended for ocean landing tests, demonstrating its commitment to achieving full reusability, a trend that aligns with the global movement to reduce launch costs in the future. It's worth noting that the FY-100 is not the company's first engine. They have previously developed two others. Ling Yudin, meaning soaring above the clouds, produces 10 tons of thrust for primary stage use, while Long Yudin, or Dragon Cloud, is designed for secondary stage propulsion. Both engines operate on the gas generator cycle and use the same propellant mixture of liquid oxygen and methane. However, I believe this is where the challenge arises. Chinese companies often copy external designs without fully understanding the advanced internal technologies that contribute to SpaceX's success. The FY-100 is an example of this problem. First, the engine appears to allocate excessive internal space to the fuel pump piping, which accounts for nearly half of its total weight.
This selection of design may limit the room for essential elements, such as the combustion chamber, which can ultimately lead to a decrease in the efficiency of the engine. Additionally, there are concerns regarding the fuel's flow path. The route for the oxygen seems to move from the pump towards the pre-burner along the outside of the engine prior to entering the primary valve. Instead of having several direct radial valves like the Raptor engine, there is only a singular valve present. This disparity between the fuel routes and other internal components might easily result in instability. Regarding the methane conduits, it appears that their pathway is either obstructed or misaligned. The fuel transitions from the main injector into the chamber, diverges into two paths, and then appears to halt abruptly. Furthermore, when observing the opposite side of the engine, an overwhelming assortment of pipes can be seen, significantly exceeding the quantity used in Raptor 3. Rather than having a singular, clear, and direct line, the FY-100 possesses several convoluted routes directing fuel towards the nozzle, combustion chamber, and oxygen pre-burner. This overly intricate configuration could result in ineffective flow distribution and complicate the task of maintaining equilibrium between the two fuels. These points represent only a selection of the significant issues apparent from the accessible images, and it is probable that additional concerns exist. You are encouraged to leave your observations and evaluations in the comment section below, as cooperative discussion often leads to enhanced understanding. In conclusion, it seems that Jishu's has attempted to imitate the exterior design of the Raptor 3 without fully grasping the internal workings. The design appears to be an effort to compress a complicated array of pipes and systems into a form intended for a much simpler, more streamlined engine. The outcome resembles the struggle of fitting a chaotic bunch of wires into a small container. The repercussions of such a strategy could be dire, as these shortcuts in design might result in imbalances in internal pressure or possibly cause explosive failures. Even if the engine endures a static fire test, its performance is likely to fall short of expectations. The thrust and specific impulse metrics will likely not measure up to those of SpaceX's engines. Meanwhile, SpaceX is advancing its next-generation propulsion technology. The Raptor 3 engine, as noted previously, is distinguished by its remarkable simplicity while representing the pinnacle of contemporary engineering and technology. This simplicity does not denote a reduction in quality, but rather constitutes a considered advancement. By eliminating unnecessary complexity, SpaceX can reduce risks, enhance reliability, and lower the likelihood of mechanical failures that were more prevalent in earlier engine versions. Each individual system, pipe, and component has been optimized or combined to fulfill multiple roles, enabling the entire engine to function with significantly improved efficiency.
The Raptor 3's efficient design significantly reduces production time, costs, and labor requirements. These advances allow engineers to manufacture, operate, and maintain the engine much faster than ever before. This efficiency is a critical step towards Starship's ultimate goal of achieving complete and rapid reusability. When engines are reusable with minimal maintenance, launch times are drastically reduced, resulting in unprecedented launch frequency. This principle underpins SpaceX's strategy for realizing its ambitious plan to operate Starship like an airplane, enabling multiple flights per day in the future. The Raptor 3's reduced mass further enhances its performance, increasing the spacecraft's payload capacity and flight efficiency. Every gram saved translates into increased thrust, a larger cargo payload, and expanded opportunities. In terms of power, the Raptor 3 represents a substantial advance. It surpasses its predecessors and even surpasses Blue Origin's BE-4 engine, positioning it as the most powerful operational methane-oxygen engine in the world. Once fully integrated into Starship, the Raptor 3 engines will produce a collective thrust of over 9,000 tons at liftoff, an unprecedented figure in rocketry. This level of thrust places Starship in a unique category. By comparison, the Saturn V rocket that carried astronauts to the moon during the Apollo missions produced about 3,400 tons of thrust at liftoff. Starship's thrust will nearly triple that amount, allowing it to carry heavier loads, accommodate larger crews, and embark on more ambitious missions to the moon, Mars, and beyond. However, SpaceX isn't stopping its development with the Raptor 3. The company is already working on future variations such as the Raptor 3X and Raptor 4. Each new version will offer further improvements in power, efficiency, and ease of maintenance. Musk has indicated that SpaceX's ultimate goal is to create a rocket capable of producing a total thrust of over 10,000 tons at liftoff. This is equivalent to the power of 3 Saturn V rockets. Achieving this target will not only mark the beginning of a new era in propulsion technology, but will also solidify Starship status as the most powerful and advanced launch vehicle ever developed. The Raptor 3 era is just around the corner. The upcoming Starship Flight 12 will feature the maiden flight of the Starship version 3 V3 configuration, which will use these innovative engines for the first time. If successful, Flight 12 will validate the Raptor 3's performance under actual flight conditions and confirm that SpaceX's bold engineering choices are indeed effective. That's it for today's episode. See you next time.